Okay, this week was a pretty good ball game for the Tigers. We got a chance to do a lot of things that we wanted to do. We got a chance to play quite a few guys. I guess when you play a game like that and ball game can kind of get out of hand, you can have the opportunity to do those things. And that's what we really wanted to do, because what we wanted to do is try to get some guys in, get some experience in and get them on the field. And we was fortunate enough to do that. We got to the point where I felt kind of bad, and we went the last half, we went to 12 minutes quarters, you know, and then I think the last quarter we kind of ran the clock instead of stopped the clock, because like I said, it was getting to the point where it was getting a little bit, I know the coach was getting a little impatient over there, so we had to make him feel a little bit better, and so we tried to end the game as soon as possible. For this coming week now, this is a ball game that we got to really be up for, because this team here beat this team last year. I wasn't here last year, but I heard a lot about it. I know they got a great coaching staff, and they does a great job teaching their young men what to do on the football field. What we got to do, we got to go out, because they got a coaching staff with about 5 to 6 years of coaching experience there. So we got to really, when we got a coaching staff, just the first year coaching staff putting it together, and we just got to go out and play our best ball game. And the key that we had last week is keeping everybody healthy. And that was one of the things that I wanted to try to keep everybody as healthy for this ball game. And so fortunate enough, we did do that. And so we should have all our pieces going into the ball game ready to play.
Okay, we'll open up for questions.
Coach, in a game like Saturday, when you expect to kind of do what you did, and what do you take away from that game where you just put it completely behind you once it's over?
Well, you know, that's the kind of ball game, I guess all coaches would love to have that kind of ball game, you know, but what we would do is take that ball game and put it behind us and get ready to play, because like I said, we're getting close to the time that we're getting ready to start and getting into the conference, and we want to get a chance to play quite a few guys last week, in which we did play probably our whole football team. But coming up this week, like I told the guys after the game, that ball game is behind us. Now we got to get ready to go play, because like I said, this is going to be a very good football team that we're getting ready to play, because they beat them last year, and these guys expected to come in there and beat them again this year. Like I told them, if we can go into the ball game, have a mistake-free football game, we don't have to worry about nobody beating us, because like I said, the first ball game we played against Florida A&M, we had 5 penalties, which that was too many. And this past week we had 7, which that was way too many penalties. So that's one of the things that we go on. We preach to these guys every day, let's go into this ball game without any penalties. We can do that, play a mistake-free football game. We can go and play with anybody, you know, we just got to play our ball game.
You said during the press conference that your coaches were looking over film from Tennessee State. From what you've gathered so far, what kind of team do you think Tennessee State is?
I tell you what, Tennessee State is a very good football team. You know, the good thing about Tennessee State right now with them, that coaching staff been together for 5 or 6 years, so they got a little bit more on us when it comes to that, because like I said, this is our first year for us putting a staff together, and we're playing a staff that been together 5 or 6 years, so I know they're going to be prepared, and we're doing all we can to be prepared for this particular ball game also.
Were you looking over film from Alabama State that they played?
Right, that's the only film that we have right now on them, you know, from the last week ball game. So we got that film broken down. We came in this morning and started breaking it down, because we didn't get the film until late last night. And so we started breaking it down this morning. So we're ahead of the game right now.
Does that help that the opponent they just faced has a familiarity to you guys?
Well, it helps, you know. It really helps the opponents, you know, because like I said, we're looking for a team that has come out with stuff that we're playing. I know they're looking at what we're doing. They don't have but one film on us. Only thing they can do is look at what we did this past week. Well, they got two now, because they had Florida A&M and this week ball game. I don't know whether they'll use this week ball game at all to try to get a game plan together. They probably go back to the Florida A&M, but they probably get a little bit more than what, because we didn't show a whole lot this past week. We kind of held back on a lot of the plays, keep from showing them.
Coach,
Any concerns as your guys play their first, I guess, road game of the season? Any concerns about them being prepared and playing in another environment besides the Vet?
I think they're prepared. You know, this is not a team that we're just putting together. This team been together for a while, you know, so they understand, they know what to expect. So all we got to do is put our game plan together and go out and execute the way we think they can execute. We should be fine. I don't think that being on the road would do anything. Like I said, it's a neutral spot for Tennessee State also. They're in Memphis. They're not at home. We're in, you know, so we're not at home. So we expect to be a real good ball game for both sides.
What kind of jumped out to you about Alabama State being able to beat Tennessee State? What kind of stood out to you from just seeing that?
Well, you know what? I think Alabama State, they had a real good game plan. They went in with the idea that they was going to win this ball game no matter what, you know. So they went in and they took it to them. You know, like I think Tennessee State played that first game. I think they played a school down in Florida. Everwater, they played Everwater, so I think they beat Everwater's up pretty good. But I think what they're knowing now, they're knowing that this ball game is going to be a tough ball game, and they're going to have to come and play because they, I think last year, I think Jackson State had about five interceptions or something like that. So we can't afford to have any turnovers in the ball game. We got to go out and, like I said, play a mistake-free football game. If we do that, I think we'll come out successful.
Going back to the penalties against Virginia Lynchburg, that was about 7 penalties, I would say, from that game. What did you see? Was Jackson State your team playing to the level of Virginia Lynchburg, or was it just miscues mentally?
Well, I tell you what, I think it was just miscues. I think it was mentally. The guy was overplaying the, you know, position or whatever, you know, but like I said, we had 8 penalties for 77 yards, and that's a lot of yards for me, you know, and I don't, like I said, that's the thing that, like I said, we preach every day, mistake-free football. We want them to the guys go out and execute the way they're supposed to execute. Don't do anything that we don't do in practice. We want you to go out like one guy, I think, hit a guy in the back. If you see the guy's number from the back, don't touch him. Let him go. We'd be better off if you don't make no mistake at all.
Coach, are you fairly healthy going into this game?
We're pretty healthy. We got one offensive tackle, Mark Murphy. I think he, you know, had a knee contusion, so he's saying that he's going to be ready to go. I think he's talking to Coach Porter yesterday, said that he was going to play because he's trying to get tickets for the game. Because, you know, if you don't practice, if they don't practice Tuesday and Wednesday, you don't play. So, you know, these guys, they can be hurting, but they still trying to get on the trip. But we only taking guys that can play for us.
I noticed you played Blake McCall, and he's a sophomore, in place for Marcus Murphy. What did you take away from him? Do you think he kind of made his case to battle for that tackle position?
I think he did. You know, like I said, I was kind of had a little doubt on Blake McCall back during the spring before he got hurt. You know, but after he got that shoulder surgery on that shoulder, he got it healed. Now he came back, and I tell you what, Blake is playing the type of ball that everybody thought he could play. So he looks really good there. You know, the good thing about that offensive line is that we don't have the depth that I would love to have at that position. So as all the guys that we get some experience at that position, I feel good about it because, like I said, we just don't have the guys there that I feel comfortable with right now.
Between Florida A&M and this game, how do you think your non-conference schedule will help you for the rigors of the SWAC?
Well, I tell you what, I was telling someone the other day, is we are not like the NFL where you have preseason football games. You know, you can go and play preseason games in order to work out the kinks and get ready for the regular season. So, but like I said, these non-conference games that we have, this is a good time for us to get all the kinks worked out so we can be ready for when the regular or when the conference game gets started. I hope we have all those things out the way that we can go out and compete against those conference football teams.
Another thing that you mentioned during the FAMU game was red zone conversion. You said, you know, we got to do better than, I think, 1 for 5 it was against FAMU. You feel like you guys are more capable of getting it done when they're in the red zone now? I mean, obviously against it's Virginia Lynchburg, y'all able to do whatever you wanted. But playing another opponent this weekend, do you feel like you guys are more comfortable in the red zone?
Well, you know what? Last week, that was one of the things that I told the coaches that we got to work on. And we worked on the red zone pretty much all last week. And I think we was in the red zone this past week, we was 2-for-2. Although we went to the end zone quite a bit, you know, so we wasn't really, say, per se, in the red zone, but we was 2-for-2 inside the red zone. But last week, we worked on the red zone quite a bit, and we're going to do the same thing this week because, like I said, you got to really put some time in the red zone in order to, because, like I said, when you get to the red zone, the field shrinks on you. You're only 20 yards to the end zone, so you don't have the room where everybody's spread it out, where everybody's back off your deep, everybody's a little bit closer, so you have to do a little bit more work down there. The players have to work a little bit harder to get open.
Was it a tough game to kind of grade Ivy on? You had a lot of wide open guys, but what did you see from him this past Saturday?
Well, you know, like Ivy, you know, the thing about him is that he's just a freshman. He's still a freshman because last year he only, played in the Tulane game where he got hurt, so he hadn't really been on the football field at all. But each week, last week, you know, we saw some growing, and this past week we saw some growing. I think each week he's going to get better. He's the guy that we all got a big saddle on. We're going to ride him, so we just got to keep him healthy, keep him upright, make sure he don't get hurt because, like I said, we don't have the depth there, I feel like, that we need. Although Ingles came in, and I was afraid of him, of course, like I said, he had a knee, and I didn't know how much that we were going to be able to get out of him, so we're bringing him along slowly because I know he's not 100% healthy. So we got to keep those two guys together.
Small note, there was a team of lineup change with the linebackers, Kwame Owens, playing for Ted Terrell. What was the decision behind that? Because I know Terrell came in later throughout the game.
Well, Terrell, you know, like I said, what's happening with him, he had a problem with his back, I think. You know, they thought it was a hairline fracture in his back, and they found like it was muscle pull or something, you know, so they gave him some antibiotic or something like that. But we didn't want to put him out there, didn't want to risk it anymore, because, like I said, this is the big week for us, so we ought to make sure he's ready to go because he's one of our starting linebackers.
Yeah, he led your team, the team in sacks last year. How do you think he is, I guess, in term for the swag opener against Grambling in September?
Well, we're hoping he'd be ready. You know, like I said, we're going to bring him along slow. Don't want to really push him too fast. You know, make sure the trainer, the doctor, them said that he's ready to go because, like I said, when we get to the conference championship, I mean, it's the conference ball game, that's when we really want him to be able to play and really be able to go out and perform. So we want to win this ball game coming up this week, but we don't want to push guys to the point where we're going to hurt them more than help them being ready for the conference opener.
Good.
All right.
Appreciate it. Appreciate it.